Welcome back to Steve Rob Reviews. Today we're going to have some fun. I got this mount all standing nice and straight here, screwed into my vise. And you know what, guys? This is a lot harder project than I thought. And for you that are just new to the channel, this is all about trying to mount a solar panel tower up at my camp and put four 100 watt solar panels on it. And what I have now is just one 100 watt solar panel on the roof of the camp, and I need a new roof bad, and I don't want to put no more solar panels on the roof itself, so I'm building this. So yeah, this is it is quite difficult. I'll tell you the truth, it's a lot more difficult than I actually thought. But I went and picked up two aluminum rails to mount the solar panels to. I got them right over there, and I'm going to show you that. I got it all kind of lined out and everything. And yeah, this is going to be, yeah, one of the toughest projects I ever tackled. So what I did is I just went and got some drill rod, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to drill four holes and mount this aluminum tubing I've got. Guys, I tell you what, price of aluminum, wow, it's just gone right through the moon. Okay, so I'll show you what I got here with this aluminum, and this will give you a better idea of what I'm trying to do. Okay, here's the two tubes here. They're 2 by 2 inch by 1/8 wall, and they're 8 foot 6 inches each. So what I've done is put a little bit of a storybook to how I'm going to mount these, and a lot of glare in here, right, guys? So between the two arrows here is going to be a panel. This is going to be two drill marks going through right to the other side. That's going to mount to the stand over there against the wall. And I marked here 33 inches from center to center. So that's the first panel. This is the second panel, and they're going to butt right up against each other. And then we get down to here, and I've left a space in between here, and there's a reason for that. And then here's the third panel, a space, and then the fourth panel, and a space at the end. So when you're deciding that you want to drill a hole, and I'm drilling half inch, so I'll be going from here right through the other side. You don't want to just start drilling like even a pilot hole from here and go right straight through the tubing down to the other side. No, what you want to do is you want to mark it all the way around, you know, and then start from this side too. So that's the same on the other side here. Oh, I didn't write my name on here. That's the steel supplier. They know me there, so they just cut the steel for me, put it off to the side, and I know which bundles to pick up myself. So that's pretty well it there. And I think it's good to mark it all out so you can see what you're doing. And you have to make sure that it all corresponds to the frame that you have. So if we take a look at this frame here, you could see that the panel is probably going to come down to about here. So the lowest the panel is going to be is roughly 30 inches from the ground. And I have to put a bolt in, bolt hole here, a bolt hole here, and same up at the top. Now what I don't know is I have to get the panels out next and measure the distance, because the panels are 4 feet wide. This is 32 inches from here to here. And I have to actually make sure I know where I'm putting these holes here so that it makes it the easiest way possible to actually rig this up. So what I got to do next is get the solar panel out and put it on this aluminum jig here. And I'll have to separate them and see exactly where the panel's going to sit on top, and how I'm going to fasten it from the bottom.
So the first thing I have to do is drill these holes out, and then we'll get back with the solar panel.
Okay guys, plan B. Everything's gone right to hell in a handbasket in 30 seconds. Guys, I got these solar panels all lined up here and nothing is right. It's absolutely right off the wall. I can't believe this is going on, but it's Pabst Blue Ribbon time, and I'm going to show you how whacked out some of this stuff can get when you get off of ordering from online. And guys, if I didn't get such a smoking deal on this, I'd complain. But you know what? I can't complain, because if you try to complain, it's a 1-800 number that doesn't exist in Canada, and it's not toll free, and you have to phone America, and I did, and they put me on hold so long, I think I spent like $40 on hold. So, up theirs. Okay, so I'm gonna show you how this went sideways on me here. I'm not too sure where this fit's going now, but it's crapola as far as I'm concerned. I'm gonna show you what's going on.
Okay, we're gonna start off here. Panel one, panel two, and there's the charge controller, and I'm not touching that. I'm not using that, no way. Panel three, panel four, and you know what, guys? This is supposed to go, and I've got it all marked here on every one. I did it myself. Positive, negative. And you follow the positive and negatives all the way along, and you join them, and there's only for two panels. So if you want to join four panels, there's the positives there and the negative here, negative there, and you come down and you can't join this to this. So you can see on this one here is a female, this is a male, and if you don't know that, well, you're going to learn that in school. And so I have to extend these leads here and this lead here. So follow this all the way over here. So one goes in here and one goes in there. And then I actually have, if you take a look here, if you follow this all the way along, here's a negative. This is the negative. This is the positive. Then we take the two leads. And the, you know, like guys, this came in a kit and this is all I got. And, you know, it is so funny. I've been sitting out here having a couple of pints, just thinking about, wow, you know, this is too much. Now, this is the company here. And, you know what? I think they dropped the ball on this big time, because these leads don't fit over to here. So this is completely wing-wang, guys. So I'm gonna un-wing-wang it and extend these leads over to here. And then when I bring you back, I have no idea what's going on.
Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed that vid. I'm gonna finish off my Pabst Blue Ribbon and I'm gonna have a good chuckle over this pile of crap here. You know what, guys? When you're dealing with online sales, sometimes it kind of goes, you know what, sideways on you. And you have to just take the good with the bad. I did get a good smoking deal on this. I'm not even sure if this stuff even works. So, I bet you I got $500 sunk into this thing, and I don't even know if it works. But we're going with it, and we're going big time. I'm going to straighten this all out. In the next vid, it's going to look normal. As normal as it can be. So if you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to join all this normalness. Guys, I tell you what, I'm just having a ball with this thing right here. I'm looking at this and laughing at it out in the garage, just wondering who in their right mind designs something like this, puts it in a box and says, go tour. So I'm having a blast here, guys. You guys take care. Cheers.